Hey guys, Matt here. By the end of this video, you'll know everything about this analytics software that runs entirely on your own website while giving you complete ownership with their lifetime license. Do they have what it takes to be a real Google Analytics competitor? What about GDPR? What about page speed? How does filtering work? If you want to support me and get the 7-day free trial without the need of a credit card, go to wp.discount/analytics. This link is also in the description of this video and in the comments. Then we are here at the website of AnalyticsWP. Now, before we go to download it and start a trial, I'm going to show you the pricing. If you go over here, you will see that they only have lifetime licenses. You know me, that's something I personally love. Also, when you have unlimited websites for $200 just once, including the agency mode, it's just perfect. If you have an agency, it's a no-brainer to get this program. It's only $200 and you get everything. But if you're just a website owner, like you have an e-commerce website or a personal brochure website, this $100 for a lifetime license is not that bad, especially when you see what you get for it. Before we go any further, let me know in the comments, do you use Google Analytics right now? And are you interested in an alternative and why? First, let's start the trial. So we click over here, download trial, fill in all your information and press over here, place order. Great. And then automatically the AnalyticsWP.zip has been downloaded to your computer. Then log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP admin,
No.
That's not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial about how to secure your WordPress website. Then on your dashboard, we go to Plugins, Add Plugin. Select the zip file, press on Open, and then we press on Install Now. And then we press over here on Activate Plugin. Wait, what? There is nothing we need to set up. AnalyticsWP is ready to go. How does that even work? You can, of course, go to settings. So let's just check it out. But before you continue, please help me out here. I mean, look at these statistics. What's going on here? Then on the settings, we can only change these settings. That's not very much, but I'm going to show you exactly what it is. Well, disable tracking for these user roles. If you enable this one, when an administrator, editor, or author are logging into your website, they won't be tracked what they are doing on your website. Can be a possibility, but you can also just leave it on. I'm going to show you in just a second with the journey how you can see, hey, that's a logged in person. You can see exactly what they are doing. There's also give these user roles access to the AnalyticsWP admin pages. The admin, if you want that, just enable it. How did you hear about us question to the checkout page? Can be very useful. And if you have a WooCommerce website, enable the email order notification. I would not do that. And hide the agency mode explanation page. That's this one if you have bought the normal license or the trial. Then we press on save changes and we can let the analytics begin. This is one of my e-commerce websites and I've installed AnalyticsWP 3 months ago. So we will be able to get a very good look at the AnalyticsWP dashboard. So we can first select from last 7 days to last 30 days, all time or a custom. Normally, of course, I would like to get the last 30 days and compare it with last year. But I haven't installed it for a year, only 3 months. So we'll be able to see all this. The first thing you see, of course, is the unique people, the total page views, views per person. And then if you have an e-commerce website, you can also see the window shoppers rate. So the amount of people who just visit one page on your website and never come back. Ow, that hurts a little bit because it's my own e-commerce website. All right, if we then scroll down, we can see just how many people have visited my website. We can also compare to Google Analytics in just a second, so you know exactly how accurate this is. Then we can see the popular referrers, websites that sent the most traffic, of course, google.com, because this website is SEO optimized really well. We have different kind of search engines all there and different kind of websites also. If we then click on this button, you can see a dedicated table with everything that's going on in the last 30 days. Pretty great. Then over here, we can see the most visited pages. Again, click over here and you can see all the pages on your website that have accumulated the most visits in the last 30 days. And of course, a very nice table is the device breakdown. we can see the top devices used by my visitors. Again, you can see that 55% is coming using their mobile phone and the others via the desktop. Good to know, so make sure your e-commerce website is responsive. Now, if this is all the data we can see for the past 30 days, that's not a serious competitor for Google Analytics. Come on, let's be real. But what if I want to see how many people come to my website via a direct referrer of YouTube? That's something I want to know. Well, how to do that? We scroll all the way up and we go into here and we're going to edit queries. With queries, we can create any kind of rule that we want to have on our analytics dashboard, and we can save them for later use. So we can press on this plus and we can select a different kind of attribute. So let's, for example, I want all the referrer contains YouTube. And then we can press apply queries. Here we go. We can see 748 people came via YouTube website, and these are the pages that they went to. Then we can save this filter, click on my filter, save current filter, save it. And now I can just change, go over here and press on apply refer is YouTube. You can of course add more queries, add more different kind of rules. We have all these attributes. We can also use these, and then you can type in anything you want. There's also another way, you can add in a new group. So within this query, you have another group, and yeah, you can create anything you want with this. What would really help me right now is to get some predefined filters from their website. Just some import or export button, or just some download button, some predefined filters that would be useful for any website. For example, if I now want to create a query about some call to action I have on my website, how do I create it? It's not in here, and it's also not in the documentation, or I missed it. Show me all the traffic that's not paid. I have to create manual filters so to do not contain these campaigns, and that's sort of a way to do it, but it would be so logical if I could just have some predefined filters. All right, then we go over here to live events. Just like in Google Analytics, when someone is visiting your website in real time, you can see it here within AnalyticsWP. Could be interesting. So if I now visit my website in another browser, you can see in the live events, it will be recorded. There we go. We have an anonymous visitor on my website, which is me, and is visiting my website right now, how to make a website, e-commerce website. And then we're going to work with me with a business inquiry. And then we go over here to secure our WordPress website. So in this live events, we can see exactly how one is walking through our website. You can pause it over here so it won't be recorded. And also the live events is interesting, but it's purely right now. If I go over here and revisit this page or refresh this page, then it will be reset and you have a blank slate and you have to wait until visitor comes to your website. But to be honest, in real life, I've never used the live events. Maybe if you have a big business, you can put it up a monitor somewhere, but I don't know. On that monitor, you might want to have the orders coming in and going out, and that might be a bit more interesting than just some live events dropping into your website. Then we can also go over here to integrations. Because AnalyticsWP, of course, can be integrated with WooCommerce, automatically enabled if you have an e-commerce website, Easy Digital Downloads to track the product views, SureCart if you have an e-commerce SureCart, but also with Elementor, Bricks Builder, Divi, and Beaver Builder. Not only that, we also can track forms. Gravity Forms, Contact Forms 7, Fluent Forms, Forminator, Formative Forms, Ninja Forms. It's really awesome. They track all these kind of forms, which is great. I only miss one, which is the Jet Form Builder. So I will be asking them to also put in this integration because that would be really nice. Something that I really love over here are the journeys. In the journeys, we can see multiple dots. We have anonymous people, so we can of course don't pin down a name on what they're doing. We have the identified people, like me. Those are basically the people that log into your website and visit your pages. And we have the people that made a purchases, like this one, anonymous with conversions. Now we also have this one, and you can see exactly that someone has paid on your order. If you click on one of these dots, we can see different kind of things. First, of course, the timestamp. Then we have the referrer, from which page did they came and where did they went on your website. Then after 6 minutes, the same person went to my gear page. Then after 22 seconds, it went to how to make an e-commerce website 2025. And then it stayed there another 27 seconds to refresh it. Maybe enter in the form on Gravity Forms. I don't know, we have to check that later out. So we can really see the customer journeys on our website. Then if you have a conversion on your e-commerce website, it looks something like this. Somebody came from Google, went to my website using a mobile phone. Then he went to one of these products, again, to another information, more information, different kind of products. And then after a while, it put all these things in its cart. Look at all these visits. Then it went to the cart. This is the cart in Dutch. And then we can see the conversion over here. We can see the conversion ID. I'm going to click on that in just a second. And then when you scroll down, we can see that what this person has been doing on mobile. It went back to the endpoint, of course. And then it went again to my main website, to the front page. And then we can see that the same person after 1 day visited my front page again on the website, and then it went again to one of my products. So then it might be showing this to someone else, like, hey, I bought this and did you see it, or share the link or something like that. Now if you want to see per conversion, you can click over here on the conversion idea, and then we are at the very specific order that we have seen in AnalyticsWP. Now I've blurred it out, of course, because of privacy. And then we see over here a screen element from AnalyticsWP. Now let me show this to you. In here we can see the order number, and then we also can see the user journey with the refer, the source event idea, and the landing page that is just went. And that's basically everything you can see in this screen element. You can also click on view journey. And then again, we are back here at the journey. So if you want to see from an order which journey they took, click on the button and you will be redirected to here. Then you can also go to license over here. You can deactivate it or refresh it or manage it. Nothing really to do over here. And finally, we also have the four agencies. This is the agency mode. You can see you just install the same plugin for agencies on a separate, I would suggest to do a subdomain. From there, you can manage all your client details, add the business name, give them different kind of tags, show different kind of reports, weekly reports or monthly reports. You can send them to them so they know exactly how their analytics is working for them on their website. This is just a great tool to use for your clients. And of course, we can completely style the reports the way you want it. On the dashboard, we can see all of our clients or just do them one by one. And if you're working with different kind of tags or categories, you can show them over here when just enable them or just disable them. And when you have Gravity Forms on your website and you go to your entries, you can see when you hover over it, this button, View Analytics WP Journey, and then you will be sent to the exact same journey and see their journey throughout your website. Now it's time to compare it with Google Analytics over here on the Google Site Kit. Let's go to dashboard. And then we can see some very different statistics for my website. As you can see, we have over here 38 visitors in the previous 28 days, which is way less than the 700. We have search traffic, only 7 unique visitors from search traffic. I don't think that's correct, dude. The problem is with Google Analytics, if my visitors don't consent with the cookie banners, because I'm in the European Union, Google Analytics will be blocked and they can't gather information. And this is exactly how it goes. You will see 38 visitors in 28 days. That's also a big reason why you should choose AnalyticsWP over Google Analytics, because this just doesn't give you any information. And you might say, well, maybe AnalyticsWP is wrong. It could be. But if you think 38 visitors, let's go to WooCommerce. We also have the analytics over here. Then we can see that we had more orders in the entire month of June, which is this month. It's now June the 30th. Then Google says we had visitors in the entire month. So that would mean that my conversion rate is more than 100% and people who are not visiting my website are actually buying products. And that's basically one of the big flaws of Google Analytics. So is AnalyticsWP GDPR compliant? Yes, because the data will not be sent to their servers because they don't even have servers. And yes, they will integrate with any cookie consent plugin, so you can actually ask people for consent before storing their information. Do you have to ask consent for your website? It totally depends on your website. Do you have, for example, a YouTube video integrated? Then yes, information is already being sent to YouTube. Do you use Google Analytics? And yes, also you need to have a cookie banner. But don't worry, a cookie plugin will work perfectly with AnalyticsWP. And then of course the last question, does AnalyticsWP have an impact on my performance on my website? Which is a very legit question. Well, they say they have been battle tested on site with millions of visits, completely compatible with everything, and AnalyticsWP stores all data in just one highly optimized database table on your server. Also good to know that their JavaScript file loads less than 1.4 kilobytes, which is about 35 times smaller than the script loaded by Google Analytics. Wow. Of course, they all have these FAQs, so you can read it on their website at your own time. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more WordPress related videos. And of course, check out this video because it's the most amazing video ever created, I think.